the stars, the ashen fly. Beneath, the nine realms move among the tree of world's many branches. Proudly standing upon the darkness, its roots delving into caverns where light will never venture. It was when a single great Ashen flew down to rest upon her boughs that the light woke among the realms. After eons, the great Ashen grew weak with age and fell from the Tree of Worlds, resting upon the plains of darkness, drawing what few breaths remained. In the throes of death, the light dimmed, and the Ashen's final three breaths became the three golden ages of light. The first age saw three creatures of the dark plains rise above all others. The Elder Dark fed upon the light and thrived. The second marked the coming of the Listener Matriarchs, titans who revered the light. The third breath was the Age of Man, Geffen's children. When the final breath ended, there would be a time of darkness. In that black age, the cities of man fell into ruin, toppled by war and emptied by pestilence and famine. Proud Lathyrus drowned beneath the ash. From dust to flesh, from darkness to radiance. Soon the Ashen will be reborn from the ruins of its old body, and a new age of light will begin. I served the Ashen long ago, a guardian to its waning light, even though it broke me with its brilliance. Now look to the mountain peak, for that is where fresh hope blooms. The Ashen is reborn. Behold the first glimmer of the light that will sweep the darkness from these plains. The cliffs ahead should provide a good vantage point. Beware, the rebirth of the Ashen will be violent. If you stare at a campfire too long, you'll dull your senses, and the Ashen is brighter than 1,000 campfires. The cliffs ahead should provide a
with you. Keep the light. Hide it. Keep it. Save it. Not safe. Not safe. Never safe. Raffets know. Devon has the ears, you see. Walking with shadows, you are. Round, round, round the fires, round, round, round. One and two, stand with the lives. Ash suckers, nothing but trouble. Soft Raffet, warm Raffet, fur and Raffet pie.
There are those that thrive in perpetual night and would extinguish these fledgling rays. We must find the Ashen and protect it from the Elder Dark. What a sight! Our world once more bathed in ashen light. You have felt the power of the ashen and survived. We will need that strength of yours. The ashen is still a sleeping child, vulnerable. We must wake it from its slumber. Before we begin our journey, we must bind your spirit to a ritual stone. If misadventure takes you, the stone will act as a beacon for from beyond Death's Veil. There's a ritual stone nearby, in the district called Vagrant's Rest. But I will need my hammer and spark to awaken it. You must find them. I fell and hit my head. When I awoke, my hammer and spark were gone. They are somewhere in Vagrant's Rest. That's all I know.
Bataran's hammer and spark. Most likely the vagrants have them. They're thieves and scavengers. They'll steal anything that's not chained down.
Give me my hammer, so I might awaken this sleeping stone. Touch the spark to the ritual stone. Bind your spirit to this place. I have searched these foothills and found no sign of the Ashen. We must consult Geffen of the Birthing Waters. She will know where to look. Geffen can be found bathing within the Annex of Light. Bridge the waters and strike out for the cliffs. There lies your way in. Geffen gave birth to humanity in the third golden age. We are but wide-eyed children, begging for the wisdom of an ancient mother. Geffen has roamed the stone-vaulted waters since before the Ashen fell. Yet, she is most fond of the Annex of Light, once a place of healing and peace. Geffen gave birth to you.
Do you dream? In my sleep, I hear my brother's voice. He once traveled this way with my father. I wasn't with them. Ahu was eldest, so it was his duty alone. Now he echoes through my slumber, calling to me. Each time is the same. He stands atop an old listener ruin, calling to me. I have found the ruin by the lakeside. Will you help me climb it?